Hello everyone, myself Vaishnavi. This video is on fundamental rights and directive principles of state policy. In this video, I will discuss on the basics of fundamental rights and directive principles, which a student must know. So, let us begin. Fundamental rights is also known as Maulik Adhikar. It is given in Part 3 of the Indian Constitution. It comprises from Article 12 to Article. These fundamental rights are available to the individual against the state. या फिर हम इसे इस तरह समझ सकते हैं कि एक व्यक्ति fundamental rights को state के against enjoy करता है. Now the curiosity arises, from where did fundamental rights originate? Magna Carta in 1215 was the first written document relating to the fundamental rights of citizen in England. So, fundamental right is also known as Magna Carta. In 1689, Bill of Rights was written, which consolidated rights and liberties of English people. Then, in France, in 1789, Declaration of Rights of Man and the Citizens was written. Following Magna Carta of England and Declaration of Rights of Men and Citizens of France, Americans incorporated the Bill of Rights in their constitution. Thus, Americans were the first to give the Bill of Rights a constitutional status. The framers of Indian Constitution took inspiration from this and incorporated a chapter dealing with the fundamental rights. Thus, fundamental right is borrowed from USA. The objective behind the inclusion of fundamental rights in the constitution is to establish a government of law and not of man. In short, we can understand as the objective is to establish a rule of law. To understand the importance of fundamental rights, we should understand the historic judgment of Menaka Gandhi versus Union of India, AIR 1978. It was held by the Supreme Court that fundamental rights represent the basic values cherished by the people of India, and they protect the dignity of the individual and create conditions in which every human being can develop his personality to the fullest extent. Also, in M. Nagaraj versus Union of India, AIR 2007, Supreme Court has held that the Constitution has confirmed the existence of fundamental rights and given them protection. Individuals possess certain human rights independently of any constitution by reason of the fact that they are humans. Moving further, fundamental rights can be classified under six groups, which are: first, right to equality, which comprises from Article 14 to Article 18. Right to freedom, it is from Article 19 to Article 22. Right against exploitation, from Article 23 to 24. Right to freedom of religion, it is from Article 25 to 28. Cultural and educational rights, Article 29 and 30. And right to the constitutional remedies, which is Article 32. It is also known as the heart and soul of the Constitution. It was said by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who was the chairman of the drafting committee. Next is directive principles of state policy. Rajya ke Niti Nirdeshak Siddhant. It is from Article 36 to Article 51. Directive principles of state policy is contained in Part 4 of the Indian Constitution. Now, what are directive principles? Directive principles of state policy sets out the aim and objectives to be taken up by the state in the governance of the country. That is, directive principles of state policy are the goals which a state must adopt while legislating the laws. This feature is borrowed from the Constitution of Ireland. Earlier, it was thought that the state is mainly concerned with the maintenance of law and order and protection of life, liberty, and property of the subjects. But today, the concept has evolved and we are living in an era of welfare state, which has to promote the prosperity and the well-being of the people. Now, one thing we should keep in our mind that fundamental rights are justiciable and directive principles are non-justiciable. फंडामेंटल राइट्स आर जस्टिसिएबल, इसका मतलब है अगर कोई लॉ इनकंसिस्टेंट है फंडामेंटल राइट से तो कोर्ट इज बाउंड टू डिक्लेयर दैट लॉ एज वॉइड, या फिर अगर किसी व्यक्ति की फंडामेंटल राइट्स वॉयलेट हुई है तो वो कोर्ट जाकर अपनी राइट्स को इन्फोर्स करा सकता है। डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स आर नॉन जस्ट, ये स्टेट की ड्यूटी है कि वो डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स को अप्लाई करे लॉ बनाते समय, और कोई व्यक्ति इसको इन्फोर्स कराने के लिए कोर्ट नहीं जा सकता है। दस डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स आर द गोल्स विच द स्टेट इज टू अटेन, एंड फंडामेंटल राइट आर द मीन्स थ्रू विच दीज गोल्स इज टू बी अचीव्ड। नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स थ्रू जुडिशियल डिसीजंस। इन स्टेट ऑफ मद्रास वर्सेस चंपाकम दोराई राजन AIR 1951, सुप्रीम कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट इन केस ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स द फंडामेंटल राइट्स वुड प्रिवेल। इन केशव नंदा भारती वर्सेस स्टेट ऑफ केरला AIR 1973 सुप्रीम कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स एम एट द सेम गोल ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग अबाउट अ सोशल रिवोल्यूशन एंड एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ ए वेलफेयर स्टेट, एंड दे कैन बी इंटरप्रेटेड एंड अप्लाइड टुगेदर। मार्क द वर्ड, दे कैन बी इंटरप्रेटेड एंड अप्लाइड टुगेदर। इन मिनर्वा विल्स वर्सेज यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया AIR 1980 सुप्रीम कोर्ट, इट वॉज हेल्ड दैट द हार्मनी एंड बैलेंस बिटवीन फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स इज एन एसेंशियल फीचर ऑफ द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन।
दोस्तों, यदि ये वीडियो आपको पसंद आता है तो आप इसे थम्सअप दें, इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल बटन भी दबा दें ताकि आगे आने वाला वीडियो जो है आप तक पहुँच जाए। और एक और बात जो सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट है, इस वीडियो को अपने आसपास के लोगों में शेयर करें। शेयर करने का पैसा नहीं लगता, उनकी जानकारी कुछ बढ़ेगी, उनका लीगल एक्यूमेन में संतहन होगा और मेरा भी हौसला अफजाई होगा। तो चलिए किसी और वीडियो पे मिलते हैं, तब तक नमस्कार, जय हिंद।